Okay, we're live in the trial of William Woodward. Says he was defending his family. We're hearing now from a survivor of the attack, and I'm joined in studio with Ken Belkin. And Ken, we keep getting cut off, but I believe the last question that I asked you about was the difference between the Castle Doctrine and the Stand Your Ground law. Is that right?
Yeah, so Castle Doctrine, that's what we have here in New York. And if someone's in your home, you know the old saying, your home is your castle.
Right.
Well, that's where it stems from, the Castle Doctrine. And if you're in your own castle, your home, and someone comes in there and they put you, you have the reasonable belief that your life is in danger or you might suffer serious bodily injury, you are then privileged to employ deadly force to defend yourself. And you would not be liable for that murder.
Okay, so
stand your ground.
That
can happen in the street. If someone comes up to you and they put you in fear for your life or serious bodily injury, you are permitted at that point to use lethal force. Where in a Castle Doctrine state, you have to retreat if it's in the street. But if it's your own home, feel free.
Okay. Tim Blake here is on the stand. He is a shooting victim, and apparently the story that we will hear from Woodward's side is that he had been harassed and basically bullied by Blake and others for weeks. We will also apparently hear about Woodward having PTSD. Apparently, he raised chickens to help him with that, Ken. Pretty typical, huh?
Yeah, it sounds to me they would have been better served, this defense team, going with a mental health defense, some sort of variation in the insanity defense. His statement that he was going to end this war tonight would indicate that he might not have known what he was doing at the time was wrong.
Right. In fact, the feuding neighbors, they called the police on Woodward and said that he was raising chickens in city limits, which I think escalated this fight even further. I mean, you just can't make this stuff up, Ken.
Yeah, I mean, this certainly doesn't go on in Brooklyn, but you know. he was raising chickens to deal with his PTSD. Anything that someone can do without hurting other people to overcome those types of issues, I'm all for.
Right.
You know, I can't speak to the victims in this case harassing or threatening him, but certainly at the time this incident occurred, you know, Mr. Woodward was not operating under any sort of fear for his life or serious bodily injury, and that's really what they need to establish.
We're back live in the courtroom now.